One riwayat it comes, two people that are in Jahannam, Allah will take them out of Jahannam. And then Allah Ta'ala will address them, كَيْفَ وَجَدْتُمَا مَقِيلَكُمَا وَسُوَ مَصِيرِكُمَا. How was Jahannam? Can words possibly describe the extent of the azab of Jahannam? There's no time to go into details. Nevertheless, Allah asked them, how did you find Jahannam? They will say, Allah, suwa maqil wa aswa masir, the worst of places. Then Allah will say to them, dhalika bima qaddamat aydikuma wa ma ana bidhallamin lil abid. It was because of your actions. I did not make zulm on anyone. Now go back to Jahannam. When this order of Allah comes, the reaction of these two people will be completely contrary. The first one will rush, he will take the chains and put it back on him and he'll start running back towards Jahannam. And the second one will stand rooted to the spot. Allah will call the first person back. Why did you run? You just said Jahannam is such a terrible place. Why did you run back? He will say, oh my Allah, in the world, I didn't obey a single command of yours. Now the realization has dawned on me. When you gave me this command to return back to Jahannam, I said, let me at least hasten to fulfill this command of my Allah. Allah will say, you are forgiven, and he will put him in Jannat. Then Allah will say to the second person, why did you not obey my command? He will say, Ya Allah, it was my husn zan. Ya Allah, you took me out of Jahannam. I did not believe it was possible you would put me back in Jahannam. Allah will say, you are also forgiven. Hadith is replete of examples of the mercy of Allah. One person comes in one riwayat. His deeds will be weighed. His evil deeds will be more than his good deeds. Despite this, the command will come, Ya Fulan, udkhul al-jannata bi'amalik. Or so and so, enter Jannat because of your amal. This person will say, Ya Allah, what amal? Ya Allah, what amal? My evil deeds were more than my good deeds. Allah will say to him, Alasta kunta na'iman dha laylata kada wa kada wa taqallabta min jambin ila jambin wa taqulu khilala taqallubik Allah, Allah. Allah will say, so and so night, Allah will remind him about his own life in the world. There was so and so night, you could not sleep. You were turning from side to side, you were restless. And as you turned from side to side, you said, Allah, Allah, Allah. Eventually sleep overpowered you and you forgot about that night. Amma ana fala ta'khudhni sinatu wala nawm. But your Allah is such, your Allah doesn't sleep. Nor does your Allah doze off. Nor does your Allah forget. Wamar kana rabbuka nasiya. Allah doesn't forget. Allah says, in exchange for the Allah, Allah of that night, I have given you Jannat.